Welcome to P&K's kitchen. As you can see, we will be making a dish called Perfect Thali. It's actually a very popular dish these days. So the ingredients you might need for this dish is bindi, tomatoes, chilies, flour and water mixed together. In India, it's called atta. Rasam powder, chili powder, yogurt or dahi, and a set of thali, and then bowls. Now we'll be starting on the cooking. As you can see, we are coming to this area where we have to cook the rotis. It's a kind of Indian pancake. It's really cool because you can cook it and yet it's not sweet. It's salty. So, we're going to start. First, take the atta. Get it in a bowl. Or a ball. When it's in a well ball, roll it in flour so it doesn't get sticky while getting rolled. It doesn't stick to your hand anymore. Now, put it in a ball again and make it into a circle. If it gets sticky on the round, put more atta on it. We should make it very thin. Our theme with this roti is chili and tomatoes. What you need, first, take tomatoes. Now take some chilies for the well spice. Spread it fairly on the roti. Now, roll it up, make it into a ball so it mixes well, and roll the roti again. Like again, if it gets sticky, put atta or flour on it. First roti is ready. Right. So, now we are making the thali. First, we need two milk. We filled not halfway through the plate. Now, remember not to spill, I am very clumsy. Now, and then we put the dahi or yogurt. Remember, do not put too much. Remember, only fill halfway or 3/4 of the way.
I'll give you the numbers right now and give you the names of it.
That's just my dad.
No, I did open everything. Oh, kept saying main door. I opened and touched everything.
Funny, right? And then, remember to put always a garnish of tomatoes.
Okay. So I will. So you, how will we name them? Should I name it myself? I can do it myself.
And then, for the day, you have to put first a pinch of mirchi powder. It's a pinch. That much. And then put a small bit. And I'm actually saying small
bit.
Of Brussels.
white one. Where is the remote?
Okay.
Hello? There's a big white one, which I assume is the motion sensor. And where is the...
So, we will be cooking the roti now. See, it has all these tomatoes and chilies in it, so it will take quite a long time. Let me place it in the pan. We have to put it in medium. Then, while it's cooking, you have to put oil on the first side. So eventually, it cooks. Funny, right? Lots and lots of oil. Make sure, lots of oil. And we should put it soon when you get to that point. You should put it at high on stuff so the fire so it can cook quickly and it will be done. And eventually, our customer is very hungry. So, where were we? As it's cooking, you should make sure that it doesn't bubble, otherwise, it's gonna burn. So, while it's cooking, it has to have these kind of brown spots on it. So it can eventually, you know what, cook well. So we'll turn it over now so I can put the oil on the other side. Because eventually it's not good to not put oil on the other side. You should somehow do it like that so the roti doesn't break. Make sure. And then have a nice coating. Otherwise it's not gonna cook well. See? So while it's cooking, we'll be cooking it well. So sorry. Well, we'll be turning it over now. Oh! Well, that's not done yet. And you should kind of... So eventually it, you know what, like really cooks, so smush it down. Yeah, like that, you see? Hear the noise? It's good. Good. It's not good to like cook it so much because then it has this kind of weird taste to it. So you have to make sure it's perfect. That's the good thing about being kids because you remember these things, right? I'll put a little more oil on the places that are kind of not cooked. So eventually it cooks a little faster because eventually the customer is too hungry. And I must turn it over now. Well, this stuff's not that great, so it's not cooking so well, but usually it would have cooked nice and brown by now. Okay, we're almost done with this one, and then we're going to start cooking the second one. I'll get the plate for putting it in, so we can put the next one in. As you can see, I have a plate here. It has to be double-sided, so no oil leaks out. Otherwise, it's going to make a real mess on the floor. So this is almost cooked now, and this tomato obviously fell out. Okay, sorry for that. It's my dad. He's eventually really into security programs.
Nope.
And my sister Neha. She's helping out. We're almost done with this one. As you can see, the color is actually coming in. We have to really squish it down. Sorry for that noise, I don't hear that. Well, we're almost done with this one. I'm just turning a few more times. As you can see, you have to turn a long time, and it might take a long, long time to cook this one. Because some don't cook very well, because they don't have the good, like, perfectness into it. So this one, I have to put it in a plate for now, because eventually, it's taking too long. Next roti.
Okay. So I had also dal, which is an Indian soup, and some rice to go with the dal. And as you can see, I put the roti. It's very soft on the edges. As you can see, you must break it in half. Neatly put it on the side. And as you can see, I've garnished most of these things. They're very nice now. The second there, you see.
Yep, it worked!
There should be some garnish. Garnish is like decorating. So, when you make your thali, you should always garnish these. As you can see, I'm almost done with this roti. I have to put some oil on this side so it cooks. And eventually it will make a really nice combination with all the stuff that you saw with my sister Kavya. See, those things that she had was a little side for these rotis. And then eventually she had...
What is it saying?
And this is eventually the main serving. Because if you don't have this, what are you going to eat with those side servings? So, as soon as we're done with this one, then the meal will be ready. As you can see, I should also put rice over there. Because she can also add the dal, which is lentils soup. You know lentils, those kind of orange round things? Not orange, yellow. So, where were we on this thing? How do you make sure it cooks really nicely, because the other one did not cook that well? As you can see, this has that brown spot on it, and it's actually really good with the brown spots. Because with the brown spots, you get the crunchiness. Hear that? This is a good roti. It's a perfect one. You should put it straight up so basically everything comes through. So my dad is going to be the customer for this. Let's hope he likes it.
Didn't you say anything?
So, well, I'm almost done. So, eventually our dish is done. Let's hope our customer likes it. Well, we have our rice, our dal, our dehi, and our bindi. We also put lots of garnish on top because the garnish gives a little flavor to it that can really finish the dish off. And here are our rotis. Yummy. Well now, let's hope he likes it. Have a great time.
Should I press the square?